Here's more wrestling news for November 28th, 2021. And your headlines for this afternoon include, Bryan Danielson feared he would die during a WWE match, Rhea Ripley thinks Survivor Series booking decision was a little bit disrespectful, Ziggler keeps promise to bear it all and break the internet, it's finally reached a boiling point recently, Seth Rollins opens up about real-life issues between Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair, why would you appear for a WWE Raw Open Challenge and then refuse the opportunity? We're starting with Survivor Series 2021, which was the 25th anniversary of The Rock's debut, and all night long, clips of The Great One's incredible career were played to fans. Fans saw The Rock's career but didn't see The Rock himself, and the closest thing we got to an in-person appearance was the egg from his new film Red Notice being featured as part of a paid advertisement by Netflix. Featuring an egg The Rock held isn't close to having the man himself, and according to Andrew Zarian, The Great One being there in person was the original plan for Survivor Series. He reports, "In July I was told that the Brooklyn, New York pay-per-view would be centered around Johnson. Between heavily promoting his new Red Notice movie on Netflix, the 25th anniversary of his WWE debut that took place in New York City, NBC's renewal of Young Rock, and the second season of the Ruthless Aggression documentary series, the timing was perfect. In late September, the same source told me that Johnson would not be on Survivor Series due to his filming schedule and needing to quarantine for travel." Zarian adds that the financial obligation between WWE and Netflix meant that promoting Red Notice still had to happen, and what we saw was the same basic concept as what was always planned, just without The Rock himself. Fans were disappointed that a show so clearly written about The Rock didn't feature him, and they didn't even get a video message by the former WWE champion. Fans wanted to honor a legend of the ring in person, not remember his career through vignettes and a commercial disguised as an angle. WWE were counting on The Rock appearing at Survivor Series, and despite knowing since September that the People's Champion wouldn't be coming, things were chaotic backstage due to the change of plans. According to Fightful Select, The Rock not appearing caused major problems backstage, as some within WWE voiced concerns for Roman Reigns to headline the show with his cousin not there. The belief was that if Reigns headlined, then fans would expect The Rock to appear in an epic conclusion to the show, which would only disappoint fans when he didn't show up. Despite these concerns being voiced, it's reported that there wasn't a major push to change the main event, and the report adds, "There were various run sheets that had the accurate rundown, but there were also numerous that were printed in reverse, which caused confusion backstage, and several thought there was a decision to switch the women to the main event because The Rock wouldn't be present. Had WWE gone with the reverse show, it would have been Reigns and Big E who would have opened the night, while the very personal war between Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch would have headlined. Ultimately, Reigns ended Survivor Series on top without having his celebration cut short by his Hollywood megastar cousin, but with or without The Rock, there was plenty of chaos last Sunday night. It wasn't just The Rock, or really the lack of The Rock, that was causing problems backstage at Survivor Series. There were also issues behind the scenes during the main event. PW Insider notes that there was what they described as a minor freakout backstage during the Champion vs. Champion main event, as those behind the scenes feared the show would go long. Survivor Series was scheduled to go off the air at 11:35 p.m. Eastern Time, and things cut pretty close with the main event between the Universal Champion and the WWE Champion. One major issue those backstage had was why every participant in the men's Survivor Series match were given so much time for their entrances, which took up vital time during the broadcast. Ultimately, WWE was able to fit everything they wanted into Survivor Series, but even had the WWE been able to get The Rock, the company wouldn't have had much time to feature the Brahma Bull. Now, Natalia Markova has made a name for herself competing all over the world, including working in the UK, Finland, Japan, and AEW. In 2021 alone, Markova has won 3 titles from 3 different companies, no easy feat, and gave fans a treat on Twitter this week. In a tweet, the wrestler posted a selfie of herself wearing nothing but the Shine Championship and promised to break the internet. This isn't the first time Markova has shared some provocative pictures, as she replicated Shawn Michaels' infamous Playgirl pose last year, once again wearing nothing but championships. Markova will continue to make a mark in the pro wrestling scene, and with her star always growing, we wonder if WWE will eventually take an interest in the talented wrestler. For the past few weeks, arguably the biggest story in WWE has been Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch, But the conflict between the two of them isn't just for show. After Flair went off script during their title exchange, the pair had a backstage altercation during the October 22nd SmackDown, which reportedly ended with the women's roster seeing Lynch as a hero. Despite their differences, Flair and Lynch put on a fantastic hard-hitting match at Survivor Series, and after the show, the man's husband, Seth Rollins, was asked about the former friendship between Lynch and Flair. "I can't even relate to the experience Becky probably went through out there tonight. When you have fallen out with your best friend, I can tell you legitimately, that's been a process, it's been going on for years. And it really reached a boiling point recently, as all the reports have said, so there is nothing about going into this match that she was comfortable with." Rollins added that the match, which saw Lynch get the win thanks to a roll-up and grabbing the ropes, was an extremely cathartic experience for her, and said that his wife is hopefully in a good place now that she's won. Lynch won, but the dirty finish last night has left the door open for a rematch between the two, and time will tell if the pair wrestle again and if their friendship can ever be mended. There was more to Raw this week than just odd fans, as the show focused on the two singles feuds in the Red Brand's women's division, Becky Lynch vs. Liv Morgan and Bianca Belair vs. Doudrop. Belair was the sole survivor in the women's elimination match, but isn't back in the title picture yet, which is a good thing for her. If she were thrust back into it, fans would have had a similar reaction as to Drew McIntyre earlier this year, when fans believed he had overstayed his welcome in the WWE title picture. Instead, Belair has a chance to show off her skills in a feud with Doudrop, who took the EST out following her win over Tamina, and has seemingly aligned herself with the former women's tag team champion. We are less impressed with the Raw women's title feud, as despite the exciting prospect of Lynch vs. Morgan, what we are seeing is the latter get chewed up and humiliated in promos on a weekly basis. It was no different this week, as the man literally made Morgan cry by bullying her before Liv attacked the Raw women's champion. "We can't get too mad at Lynch, who is probably the best promo on Raw, male or female, and she started Raw with another masterclass promo." Even her face-to-face segment with Liv showed how good Lynch can be, but it came at the expense of Morgan, who continues to look less credible each time we see her. This seems to be a sink-or-swim feud with Morgan, and we're wondering why WWE are doing all they can to make Morgan look bad against someone who's already on a higher level than her. Before Money in the Bank this year, the future seemed golden for Morgan, but somehow, the 27-year-old superstar seems less likely to win the Raw Women's title now that she's in a feud with the champ herself. Bryan Danielson shocked everybody by appearing at All Out mere months after headlining WrestleMania 37. Bryan's involvement in the Universal title match was a last-minute addition, and Bryan has previously said that he felt an odd detachment when facing Roman Reigns and Edge during WWE's biggest show of the year. Speaking on Casual Conversations, Bryan explained this detachment at WrestleMania and how he feared the worst would happen in the ring. "When I walked out for the match at WrestleMania, I felt so empty. Fans were cheering and all that kind of stuff. When I wrestle, I feel everything. What I remember most about that match is just feeling empty and thinking, oh man, I legitimately felt like I'm gonna die. Is this a premonition that I'm gonna die? And I wasn't even freaked out." Given that WrestleMania was WWE's first show with fans back, albeit in a limited capacity, it's strange that Bryan felt empty hearing the roar of the live crowd for the first time in over a year, and it only went to show that after 11 years, Bryan needed a break from WWE. Now, as Survivor Series Raw's women's team triumphed over their SmackDown counterparts thanks to a star-studded group. Team Raw consisted of Bianca Belair, Carmella, Zelina Vega, Liv Morgan, and Rhea Ripley, the latter competing without her tag team partner Nikki A.S.H. Speaking to Sportskeeda, Ripley, who was tag team champions with Nikki during Survivor Series, discussed her partner's omission and didn't hold back at WWE. "I think I'm more disappointed than Nikki is because she's such a positive person. Yes, I know she's upset. To not have her on the team is a little bit disrespectful. To have one half of your tag team champions on the team and not the other half, it seems a little bit silly." On the post-Survivor Series Raw, Nikki and Ripley lost the Women's Tag Team Championships to Queen Zelina and Carmella, and between taking the pin for her team and disrespectfully being unused the night prior, it seems WWE's plans are over for the resident almost superhero. Raw also saw what could be the weirdest booking decision we've seen in WWE all year, and with a golden egg heist, zombies acting as lumberjacks, and a haunted doll all happening in 2021, that's saying something. When U.S. champion Damian Priest had an open challenge, the call was answered by Apollo Crews, who then refused to wrestle the Archer of Infamy. Crews, who hasn't held a title since August, had everything to gain and nothing to lose, and if he didn't want to answer the open challenge, why accept it in the first place? At least Crews got to stretch his legs by walking to the ring, only to walk away, but we can't see why anyone thought this idea was a smart call. Earlier this year, Ric Flair chose to leave WWE, citing frustrations over the booking of both himself and Charlotte as his decision to leave. Speaking on his Woo Nation Uncensored podcast, Flair said that he'll never go back to WWE and accused Nick Khan of erasing his legacy, saying that the company wanted his intellectual property years ago and tried to get it at the worst possible time. Flair explained, "Let me just tell you something else that should not shock the world. When I saw that they took me off the opening and all that for whatever reason, you know, who knows? I call it a lack of respect. Some people said to me, 'Rick, how do you feel about that?' I said, well, after they asked me to sign my intellectual property to them while I was on life support, nothing that company does surprises me." Flair has said he'd rather die in a ring than spend another month in the ICU, and we'll have to see where his last match happens, if it happens at all. There are rumors that Flair will join AEW, as it's believed the heat from Dark Side of the Ring is finally dying down. But until then, the Nature Boy will continue to keep searching for a company that'll work with him, one that won't wait until he's on life support to get his IP. Well guys, that's our news for today. Please share your comments below. Also hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon to receive all notifications. And as always, thanks for watching.